श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय हरये परमात्मने प्रणतः क्लेशनाशाय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। विद्यापीठ विधातारं विद्यावारिधि चंदिरं विद्यार्थी वत्सलं वंदे महामहिम सद्गुरु श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। By paying my humble pranams and namaskaras to all the respected ladies present over here, Pooja Shri Mami Avaru, Pooja Shri Vaini Avaru and all the other chief guests present here, I would like to start my speech regarding the topic about what the duties or what the responsibilities a woman has upon her shoulder. I would like to start my speech by considering this verse from the Shanti Parva of Mahabharata, which says, Grihini Griha Muchyate. Exactly what is Griha and what is a Grihini? Who is a Grihini? A Griha is something which has everything in it. Everything in the sense, consider it money, food, grains, clothes, all the necessary items, the materialistic items, everything in it. It is a place where one longs to go after a stressful day so that he can relieve all his stresses. And the another replica of this griha is a grihini. So the entire caretaking process lies upon the shoulder of a grihini. The moment I say this, immediately a question arises in our mind. Why is this entire caretaking process only upon the shoulder of a woman? Why can't men do it? Let me give you an example for this. So, in a home, like whatever duties are to be performed, everything should be done by women, right? This is what we are being taught by our elders, and this is the process which is being carried on since ages and ages. See, let us consider a task of nurturing a child. When you assign this task of nurturing a kid to a man and a woman simultaneously, then for sure a woman will be able to do it more perfectly, more efficiently, with lot of techniques, strategies and more amount of emotional maturity. See, it's not like a man can't do this. He can do, but when we are comparing, so obviously a woman is more efficient in this task. So exactly what is woman empowerment? It is like we should work upon our strengths. If we have this as our strength, then let us surely work upon it. Why do we always compare ourselves with the men? Why do we always go out? See, a man, he has to go out in order to become efficient. Whereas a woman, if she either stays at home or she goes outside, she has that capacity to become efficient. So, beginning my speech with this topic, what are the duties to be performed by a Grihini? A Grihini, a woman, she carries on many roles during her entire lifetime, starting from her birth until the end. She first is born as a daughter to her parents, then she enters as a daughter-in-law to her in-law's house, she becomes a wife to her husband, then she becomes a better citizen in the society, and finally she grows up to be a grandparent to the grandkids. So now let us see what all duties are to be performed by her in every stage of life. First, she is a daughter to her parents, right? What is the main responsibility of her? According to me, the primary and sole responsibility of a daughter is to shower love and respect to her parents. See, our parents have done us or have given us many things. We cannot completely do anything to repay them back. So the least we can do, or the way we can show gratitude to them, is by listening to them, by paying heed to their orders, by walking in the way shown by them. See, in a house there will be many misunderstandings, many sort of conflicts arise. But whatever it is, we do not become small by listening to them, by listening to our elders. So the least way, the minimum and the most minimum thing which we can do by paying gratitude to our parents is to respect them, is to listen to them. Then next, she enters as a daughter-in-law to her in-law's house. The problem doesn't arise for men here because they'll be remaining in their home from the beginning itself. Whereas a woman, she has to go to another house. She has to adapt to the new surroundings, to the new mindsets of the people living there. So, in today's scenario, we get to find many people, they have a mindset like they do not need their in-laws staying with them. But this is a very ironical situation here, because if our in-laws stay with us, then it is like a pure gift to us. Why is it a gift? Because when our in-laws stay with us, it is like a free guide to us, that too for an entire lifetime without any cost. There is no cost for this. If you have to hire any travel guide, you have to pay him some lump sum of money. But when you have your in-laws with you, they'll guide you, that too without expecting anything in return, that too lifetime, and moreover free of cost. All these opportunities you have when your in-laws are staying with you. How do we get the experiences from our in-laws? Why can't we just simply read from a book or get it to know from someone? Why do we always want them to stay with us so that from their experiences we can learn? There is an answer for this. Experiences matter a lot. How? Let me tell you an example. See, we all travel daily in busy roads. We get to see the signboards. Don't drive fast, else it will lead to accidents. Okay? We all are familiar with these signboards everywhere. But by simply reading those signboards, do we stop and do we go slowly? No. If we witness an accident, then surely that experience, it will stick in our mind. Then it will, like, whatever, what I'm trying to say is, with any experience, if you witness any experience, then it will stick to your mind permanently. Let me give you another example. Smoking is injurious to health. We get to see many pamphlets here and there over explaining this. If we just simply read this, do we believe that smoking is really injurious to health? No. But when we witness a person who has smoked a lot and who has seriously got some certain diseases and who has recovered from it, if that person says, yeah, smoking, it really caused a lot of effect to me, then surely we'll believe it. So if our in-laws stay with us, then they'll guide us. We get to know our cultures and traditions of our home. They guide us in such a way. So the main duty of a daughter-in-law is to take care of her in-laws as the same way she respects her parents. The next, she becomes a wife to her husband. This role of a woman, this role of a grihini is very important because this is the role she plays for a longer period of time in her entire life. There is a verse which is written some centuries ago. Karyeshu Dasi, Karaneshu Mantri, Rupecha Lakshmi, Kshamaya Dharitri, Shayaneshu Rambha, Bhojeshu Mata, Shaddharma Yukta, Kuladharma Patri. These are the six virtues a woman, especially a better wife, should possess within her. What are those? Karyeshu Dasi, which means a woman, she should work. It's not like we are treating a woman with a servant. It's like how a person, if he is assigned a particular task, he excels in it. The same way, woman, whatever task is assigned to us, by showing versatility, we excel in all those. Then next, Karaneshu Mantri. It is like a wife, she, surely husband is like a king to the house. Then wife, she is like a minister. She expresses or she advises like a minister to the husband. Then next, Bhojeshu Mata. She feeds like a mother. She takes care of herself as well as the family needs entirely by keeping in mind their nutrition values. And then next, Shayaneshu Rambha. She pleases with her inner beauty. Then next, Rupesha Lakshmi. She has all the attributes within her. Then finally, Kshamaya Dharitri. She has the essence of forgiveness like similar to that of Bhudevi. So these are all the six virtues which is to be possessed in a wife. Then finally, she enters the role of a grandmother. And the main duty of a grandmother is to teach her grandkids, because during the stage of parenting, they'll not have particular time to show towards their kids. So it is the duty of a grandmother to especially train the child towards the spirituality and morality. So a woman in each and every phase of life, she plays a very important role into forming a better citizen, into training the children to form a better citizen in the country. And finally, it's not just simply like I'm saying this, I have already idolized I have idolized these two people throughout my life. One is Pujya Mami Avaru and another one is Pujya Vaini Avaru, because it's not just simply like I have already said, experiences matter a lot. And these experiences, initially my father have taught me, and now my husband. Both of them have completely explained about they have excelled their role in each and every part of their life, and they have been excelling it further. So I would like to conclude my speech describing about the qualities a woman should possess in each and every part of her life. Thank you. Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು. ಸೊ ಅನಗ ಟಾಪ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಉತ್ತಮ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಾಗ ಮಾತಾಡ್ದಿ. ಜನರಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ತಿಳಿಯುವಂಥ ಭಾಷೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷು. ಮರಾಠಿ ಕೆಲವ್ರಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಕೆಲವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಯಾರು ಮರಾಠಿ ಒಳಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ಕನ್ನಡದೊಳಗೆ ಇವ್ರಂಗೆ ಎರಡು ಮಿಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳಂತೇಳಿ ನಾನು. ಅದಕ್ಕಿನ್ಮೇಲೆ ಸೌಭಾಗ್ಯವತಿ ಮೃದುಲಾ ಹಬ್ಬು ಅವರು ಒಂದು 10 ನಿಮಿಷ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ.